Welcome to the Parish Church of St. Bartholomew the Great in the City of London. We're here to celebrate this magical time, whether you're young or old, Christmas. For the next hour, we'll be discovering the stories behind some of our most popular carols. We'll even get to sing them as we revisit that wondrous event that happened all those years ago in the City of David. I'll be travelling to the Holy Land to discover what inspired the writers of carols that have been sung for hundreds of years, from O Come All Ye Faithful to Away in a Manger. I'll also visit the World War I graves of Belgium to learn how Silent Night played a dramatic role in one of the bloodiest wars of modern times. In Italy, I'll travel to the medieval town of Assisi to find out more about St. Francis, the man who many claim is responsible for popularizing what we know today as Christmas carols. Joining me to sing these beautiful pieces of music are the Adventist Vocal Ensemble and the boys' choir Libera.
Where are my
All the Christmas carols that we enjoy singing so much, once in Royal David City included, have all been inspired by one major occurrence, the birth of Jesus. So I'm back where it all started. This is the Holy Land. I'm in the town of Beit Sahur, a few kilometres southeast of Bethlehem. This is the Shepherd's Field, and it's where the story of Jesus really began. According to tradition, this is where the angel Gabriel appeared to the shepherds, informing them of Jesus' birth. This is the cave where the shepherds slept. The often parodied "While Shepherds Watched Their Flocks by Night" tells this story beautifully. It's also regarded as one of the oldest carols in existence. And here to perform this 300-year-old carol are the boys' choir Libera. I'm in the Holy Land in search of the stories behind some of our best-loved Christmas carols. At the heart of Bethlehem in Manger Square is the Nativity Church, the birthplace of Jesus. The church was built over the grotto where Mary is said to have given birth to her baby boy. This remarkable building was first built by the Roman Emperor Constantine back in the 4th century AD.
Hi,
And down these steps is the exact spot where Jesus was born. It really does bring it all back to me. 24 years ago, I sang down there as a chorister. What I remember from being here as a boy was the crowds from all over the world. And that doesn't seem to have changed very much. Nor does their habit of bursting into a carol. The events in the manger are now reenacted in nativity plays at schools around the world at this time of year. I remember mine fondly, especially because it gave me a chance to sing a carol I absolutely adored. I still do. I'm often ridiculed for saying that my favourite carol is Away in a Manger, but I stick by my choice. Yes, it's a simple, unscriptural carol, but being here at the birthplace of Christ has really brought alive its magical quality. It has a childlike innocence. Yes, it's childish, but in the best sense of the word. It makes you focus on the message. It's a wonderful prayer that Jesus is always at our side, looking after us. It was written anonymously in 1885, and for me that mystery makes this carol even more touching.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. The cattle lowing, the baby awakes, but little Lord Jesus no crying he makes. I love thee, Lord Jesus, look down from the and stay by my side until morning is nigh. Hear me, Lord Jesus, I ask thee to by me forever, and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in thy tender care, and fit us for heaven.
Located just a few minutes' walk from the Church of the Nativity here in Bethlehem is the Milk Grotto Church. The church gets its name from the white-coloured rock on the floor. The tradition holds turned that colour when a drop of Mary's milk fell on it while she was nursing the baby Jesus. And this beautiful icon marks the spot where it happened. the churches and the chapels that I've visited in Bethlehem, here you get a real sense that the focus is on Mary, the Mother of God. And I can't think of a carol that tells this story better than the one written in 1956 and made famous by none other than Harry Belafonte in the same year, and then again by Boney M. in 1978.
Long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible said, Mary's boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on glorious day. Hark now, hear the angels sing. New king's born today, that man will live forevermore, and all because of this day.
While shepherds wash their flocks by night, they see a bright new shining star.
They hear a choir sing,
the music seems to come from a
Although it's the birthplace of Christianity, today less than 10% of Bethlehem's population is Christian. But the faith is still kept alive thanks to the efforts of a small number of Christian priests born and bred in the city, like Father Ibrahim Shumali. Father, you were born here in Bethlehem. You're a priest here in Bethlehem. How important are carols to this town?
Carols are very important for this town because carols were born here. So it's very important for the city, for the people living here in the city.
I remember as a small boy growing up in Wales, you know, every Christmas we'd sing carols all of the time. Is it the same for children here?
The same for children in all over the world, especially here in this place. They do it, they put cassettes, CDs, they sing it with joy and with hope. It's very nice.
How important do you think carols and carol singing is for the world in general?
It's very important because, you know, birth of a person in a family is very important. And also it's hope. Hope is very important. And carols here give hope for a people with no hope, especially in this country, in this area.
And what's your favorite carol?
Ashidu Nashida. It's actually in English, O Come All Ye Faithful.
It's a good carol.
It's a very nice one. We sing it in a lot of languages.
Jerusalem is only a short drive away from Bethlehem. And here in Jerusalem Old City, the nativity story is big business. You can tell I'm in the Christian quarter of Old Jerusalem because everywhere you look, there's religious imagery. There's a wooden nativity scene, wooden mother and child, wooden Jesus on the cross. Seeing as I am a tourist in Jerusalem, after all, I can't leave without a stuffed camel, can I? But to be honest, I'm not here to shop. Father Shamali has inspired me to come to the heart of Jerusalem to introduce his favourite carol, an apt location for what many see as the mother of all carols. Sunrise over the Mount of Olives in Jerusalem, which is considered to be one of the most religious sites in the Jewish faith. Tradition tells us that this is where the world's creation began. So where better to celebrate a carol that's loved the world over? It's been translated into more than 38 languages since it began life as the Latin Adeste Fidelis. It is, of course, O Come All Ye Faithful.
O come all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. O come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. God of God, light of light, though he abhors not the virgin's womb. Not created. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. Yea, Lord, we greet on this happy morning, Jesus, to thee be glory give. Word of the Father, now in flesh appearing, O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord.
Sing, birds of angels, sing in exaltation, sing all his praises and soul above.
Ever since Jesus was born, Christians have been making pilgrimages to Bethlehem, eager to feed off the spiritual energy of the place. Some of these pilgrims have been inspired to write melodies and lyrics, that have survived for centuries. On Christmas Eve, back in 1865, a vicar from Philadelphia, Phillips Brooks, rode into Bethlehem on the back of a donkey. He was so moved by his experience here that back home in the USA, he wrote the words to one of our most loved carols. Looking out over the little town of Bethlehem, just as Phillips Brooks must have done before me, and experiencing the quiet beauty of the early evening, this really is a place where you do feel closer to God. To fully understand how carols have become such a part of our lives at Christmas time, we need to leave the Holy Land and travel to Assisi. a medieval town in the heart of the Umbrian countryside in Italy. This is the birthplace of St. Francis, but also the birthplace of carols as we know them. St. Francis found peace with God in nature and would spend much of his time here, the Hermitage, a hillside just outside Assisi. Lying in the grass, listening to the melodies of birds in the trees, he reflected on how best to portray the story of Jesus.
And this is where St. Francis came to meditate and be at one with nature. He thought that by using music and imagery, he communicated God to the masses.
Using religious lyrics in his sermons sung to the popular everyday tunes of the 13th century, his congregation sang what we now call Christmas carols. Today, monks still live and work in the Basilica of St. Francis, and giant frescoes along the walls and ceilings tell the story of this extraordinary man. Songs still remain an integral part of their existence.
So in a way, St. Francis would be quite happy that now we have modern carols sung all around the world.
Of course, because this would be the completion, it would be the maturing of his wishes, of his ideas, you know. Francis is the promoter of common people ideals, of common people practices, of course, the good ones.
I feel this next carol reflects St. Francis's message and captures the mystery of this beautiful town. It's called Rejoice, or to give it its proper Latin name, Gaudete.
Thank you.
No Christmas carol story is as poignant or powerful as that of Silent Night. To tell it, we've come here to the battlefields of Ypres, Belgium, where in 1914, British troops were locked in combat with the Germans, until a sudden break in fighting on Christmas Eve.
So Christmas Eve, 1914, what actually happened here?
Well, the Great War's been on for 4 months by this time. The conditions are absolutely appalling. The weather conditions were appallingly bad here in the lead-up to Christmas. It had been torrential rain, and actually on Christmas Eve, the German artillery had been very active. There'd been a lot of firing during the day, been a lot of sniping. But around 7:30 in the evening, everything started to die down, and an uneasy calm descended across the battlefield.
So what happened then?
What happened then is that the British sentries start to hear noises in no man's land. And when they listened closely, the Germans were singing Silent Night in German.
You see, if I was in that trench and all of a sudden I hear Silent Night being sung at me in German, that would really freak me out.
Well, I mean, to begin with, they were certainly very suspicious. They thought it probably a trick, but once they've got their head around the idea, actually, this is far better than shooting at one another. We'll join in. They had a bit of an unofficial carol contest.
I've sung Silent Night, or Stille Nacht, many times as a boy and as a man, and I've never really understood its poignancy until now. I can't begin to imagine what it was like for those soldiers hearing the beautiful melody floating over a hopeless battlefield. It must have stirred up so many emotions inside them, primarily a longing for a better, safer life back at home. For some of them, it was quite possibly the last piece of music that they ever heard in their short lives. It's made me realize how powerful and emotive a carol it really is. But as if this event in itself wasn't astonishing enough, here in the nearby Mezen church, the German forces could monitor the battlefield below as they treated their injured in what was then a makeshift field hospital. And whilst the German troops sang Stille Nacht out in the trenches, a young Adolf Hitler sheltered here in this crypt. By all accounts, he was seriously injured. Now, if he hadn't have made it through, what a different world it might have been.
Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child. Silent night.
Silent Night, a carol that touched so many people's hearts during that difficult time and continues to move us to this day. Well, I hope you've enjoyed our celebration of words and music, and I sincerely hope you have a happy and a peaceful festive season. Merry Christmas.
The Godhead see, hail.